Welcome along to the final, well, penultimate day of action, the final day of action for the women at Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiade. But Provolog, the venue once again, as we look up on the piece, the gates will tell you that the last day of action for the women is the slalom event, and they will be racing for their fourth and final individual gold. Run one coming up. Slightly colder than it has been, partly cloudy, as you can see a few crystals in the air, a magical feel to the Fonpas Provolog this morning. But who will take home the last of the individual gold medals for the women? Alternating blue and red gates. And as we look up the piece, we can see it's a 53 gate challenge. Here is the start list. We have 67 racers in run one. The top 15 going in a random order, then from 16 down to 67 on the FIS points list. And some of the athletes to look out for: Petra Smaldori of Italy, who goes at four. She ran the quickest time in the slalom leg of the Alpine combined. Jessica Freire just going through there at number 15. Three-time gold medalist from these Winter Universiade Games. Two individuals, the Super-G and Alpine combined, and one from the Parallel Nations event only 24 hours ago. So there is the track. Very steep, very, very icy. And the start right on the steepest part of the challenge. And so they'll take plenty of speed into the opening turns. Switzerland and Russia, top of the medal table, and it is Switzerland and Lara Zürcher who gets this first run underway. And Zürcher, 23 years of age, 33 Euro Cup starts. Into the rhythm of that track. We've got a chance to see this first set of gates. Zürcher doing nicely the first time split. And the clock seems to just be playing up at the moment. And Zürcher into this final stretch. There we are. There it is. And she'll stop the clock at 47.61. Time split of 30.73. Next out of the gate for Russia, Anastasia Gonostayeva, the 19-year-old. She raced at the Slalom World Cup. She's in trouble right into the back seat and has to put in an emergency turn. Now, can she keep the nerves under control and ski this second half nicely? Better from Gornostayeva, but the steep section just catching her out of the hairpin, then back into the rhythm, then an offset hairpin, and she's still quicker. The error not taking away from the clock as much as it might have done because it came on the steep section. 400th the right side of the clock at the first time split, and Gornostayeva goes second, 200th off the pace of Zürcher. Next in the start hunt, it's the lady who got the fastest run in the Alpine combined slalom leg, Petra Smaldori of Italy, 21 years of age, 30 slalom podiums in her career, none this season, however. She's been getting better and better, but she's out. So, huge disappointment for Smaldori. Ekaterina Tekhachenko, the gold medalist in the giant slalom for the Russian Federation, 24 years of age. And 26th in the World Championships in Aura at the beginning of February. And Tekhachenko, part of the Russian team that took silver in the Parallel Nations team event. And, 7. And Takachenko absolutely flying. 0.4 to the right side of the clock. Takachenko, beautifully done. Can she bring this advantage to the line? No, she can't. She's lost over half a second on those bottom turns. The top turns, brilliant from Takachenko. Number 8, Denise Dingsletter from Austria, 21 years of age, 4 Euro Cup starts under her belt. 3 top fives this season. Won a couple of CIT races. Now Dingsletter, silver medalist behind Takachenko in the giant slalom at the first split time. Finds herself 1600, the right side of the clock, but nobody before her has been able to ski this bottom half as quickly as Zürcher. And Dingsletter does though, and she extends the lead to nearly a quarter of a second. The Austrian goes to the top of the leaderboard, Zürcher into second. Next up with bib number 10, it's Carmen Aro of France. Had a blistering slalom leg in the Alpine combined, went from 15th onto the podium, up into third place. It was the fourth quickest time, but can she ski a quick time? Oh, big error on that left-footed turn. And the double gate, she's in real trouble, but somehow stays on her feet. Aro through the hardest part of the challenge. Continuing to drive these shorter skis, and she's picked up some speed, but has she picked up some time? 30.57. Oh, it is quick. It is very quick. And Aro is 0.36 the right side of the clock. It's pretty much on the edge of your seat stuff from Carmen Aro, but it's effective. And if she can get to the bottom, she might well lead. 47.37. Too many errors in the end, but 0.31. It could have been a lot worse. She shakes her head. But when the dust settles, I think she'll be pretty happy with that time. Maria Pau of Spain, bib number 12. Denise Dingsletter of Austria leads the way, 47.37. The Spaniard is on her way. 25 years of age. The most experienced of racers in this field. It's nicely done through that double gate. And Pau skiing nicely on these opening turns. This looks quick. We'll wait and see what the clock says at the first split. With Pau trying to drive these turns, accelerate through them, coming to the offset hairpin, and just 8/100ths off the pace of Dingsletter. This is a very good run from Maria Pau of Spain onto the flatter section. This is where it's so key to drive the turns. Keep the speed high, tucks for the line. And it's 1900ths off the pace. Good work from Maria Pau. Denise Dingsletter leads after the first run of the women's slalom. 47.37 her time. Maria Pau, 0.19 off the pace. Zürcher, 0.24, but it's very tightly bunched in the first 6, separated by a third of a second. The bubble for 30th, well, we'll have to wait and see confirmation. I make it, it's Milena Fokina who will get us underway. And as you can see, we'll only have 38 runners in the second run. That is a high attrition rate. We started with 67. It shows you how hard that first run was. So as usual, the fastest 30 going in reverse order. And well, there was a high degree of erosion in the first run. But this is a very difficult and challenging piece, this view out of the start hut. You definitely wouldn't want to be tobogganing down here, you'd get some pace. It is super icy, super steep, super slick, and the edges have to be sharp. Here is the start list for this women's second run. The fastest 30 in reverse order from the first run. So Melina Fokina, the 30th quickest, 5 seconds off the pace of our leader. And we work our way down. And really, the winner probably going to come from the top six. They're separated by just a 0.33 of a second. Lia Chapuis there, seventh after the first run. As we turn over the page, you'll see the quickest from the first one. Number 8:30 there, Denise Dingsletter, 47:37. But I reckon anywhere from Takachenko down to Dingsletter is capable of the gold, and possibly anyone inside the top 10. So the scene set for this final run of the ladies' slalom. Can Russia find themselves another gold, or will Austria continue to dominate the women's program? Bib number 5, Kenza Lecheb of France. 8th quickest after the first run. 0.32 an advantage over our current leader, Nelly Pierre of Sweden. Lecheb skied very nicely in the slalom leg of the Alpine combined. It was about 10 gates shorter than the slalom track, and that was a one-ski turn. Brilliant reactions from Lecheb to stay in the course. This looks quick. What does the clock say? The clock says it's very quick because she's added 0.4 of a second to her advantage. She was pumped up at the top, giving everyone high fives, and she's delivered it into her skiing. Lecheb driving for the line. Can she add to the advantage at the bottom? She can. By 0.09, that's excellent skiing for Lecheb. She increased her lead throughout, and she goes top of the standings. Bib 14, Lia Chapuis of France. Her advantage over Lecheb, 0.07 of a second. She was 0.76 slower than our leader after first leg, Dingsletter. So she needs to try and pick up time, at the same time apply pressure to those at the bottom, at the top of the hill, still to go. And at the first split time, the green light has gone red. She's lost 0.61 in those opening turns. If she can find the sort of finish that Matsumoto had, then she might be able to get herself on the podium here. France to go 1 and 2. They do, and she does find time, but not enough. Only at 0.06. Ekaterina Tkachenko from the Russian Federation. Her advantage over Lecheb, our current leader, is 0.43 of a second. Tkachenko, a silver medalist in the parallel team event and a gold medalist in the individual giant slalom, looking for yet another medal. She's got another teammate in front of her, but this is great skiing from Tkachenko. She's added over half a second to her advantage now at 0.9. Tkachenko absolutely flying. Great stuff from the Russian athletes, and we have ourselves a new best time. Oh yes, 1.14, the right side of the clock. That is super skiing, from 0.43 up to 1.14 up. Excellent stuff from Tkachenko. Carmen Aron of France, 5th quickest after the first run. She has nearly half a second on our current leader, Ekaterina Tkachenko from the Russian Federation. And Aron not looking as smooth as Tkachenko on these opening turns. Now can she get it under control and accelerate on the bottom part? And she loses 0.8 of a second in the turns to the time split. And now all will not be knocking Takachenko off the top of the podium, but she is second, but it's a huge gap, 1.11. Bib number two from the Russian Federation. It is Anastasia Gornostayeva. Gornostayeva, the 19-year-old who raced the slalom at the Alpine World Championships last month. Four Europa Cup starts in slalom, two finishes. Her advantage, 700. So her compatriot, Takachenko. And at the next time split, she's lost that. She's 0.35, the wrong side of the clock. And can she find that back? It's possible. Gornostayeva looking to make it a Russian 1-2. Driving to the line. Gornostayeva, 132.45. She's outside it. Goes second by 0.8. Bib number one, Lara Zürcher of Switzerland, third quickest after the first run. Her advantage over Takachenko, a measly 9/100ths of a second. Zürcher, 23 years of age, 33 Europa Cup starts under her belt, one podium, but that came in an Alpine combined, which combines speed and slalom. Now Zürcher, can she back up her first run with a quick second run, 116.22. Oh, she's a long way off the pace. Takachenko flew down this second run. Takachenko's time 44.76, nearly 3/4 of a second faster than anybody else. And Zürcher unable to live with the pace set by Takachenko. Can she get on the podium? No, she can't, into fifth place. So Takachenko will pick up her third medal. Bib number 12, Maria Pohl, second quickest after first round, but 1400's her advantage over Takachenko. But Takachenko, our leader, absolutely flew down this second track. She has skied it nearly 3/4 of a second faster than anybody else. And so it is a big ask for Maria Pohl to reel this one in. And there's an error from Pohl. You feel it has to be super clean this run, otherwise it's not going to be a gold medal for it. The Spaniard is, well, 0.87. That is how quick the Russian Takachenko was over the track. And Pohl, well, it's 0.8 of a second to get into second place. Where she got into? Sixth. 1.33 off the pace. So here she is, Denise Dingsletter, the 21-year-old, the leader after the first run. Her advantage over Takachenko, the current leader at the bottom of the hill, 0.33 of a second. Takachenko was sixth quickest after the first run. Dingsletter was the quickest. Takachenko on fire, though, in this second run. Skiing a super fast, super clean line, but Dingsletter is going to have a match. And things are so far so good. Was that an error? Looked to get hit out of her rhythm. It doesn't look anywhere as quick as Takachenko. And, well, it's nowhere near. She's lost 6/10, but she's got to keep driving here. It's possible to get 0.45 back. So this is still on for Dingsletter, but she's got to drive down here. She's got to accelerate out of every turn. 132.45 tonight. Takachenko knows she's outside, but she takes silver. Dingsletter is into second. Hello off the podium. The two Russian athletes celebrate, but Ekaterina Takachenko wins her second gold of these games. She does the technical double, giant slalom and slalom. So confirmation then, Ekaterina Takachenko, the Russian Federation, picks up her third medal and second gold of the Alpine program at the Winter Universiade. Denise Dingsleder, well, she adds another medal to her name. She was silver medalist behind Takachenko in the giant slalom. She's silver medalist behind Takachenko in the slalom, but she also has a gold from the team event. And Gornostayeva from the Russian Federation picks up her first medal with a bronze. So now the flower ceremony for the women's slalom. And Elena Gavrilova, the general director of Fun Park Bobrovolog, will do the honors of presenting the flowers.
Third place, representing the Russian Federation, Anastasia Gornostayeva.
Anastasia Gornostayeva from the Russian Federation picks up her first medal. It's a bronze for the 19-year-old. Brilliant performance from her.
Second place, representing Austria, Denise Dingsleder.
And Denise Dingsleder of Austria picks up her third medal of these Alpine programs, two silvers in the giant slalom and slalom, and a gold in the team event. Brilliant performance again from Dingsleder.
Third place, representing the Russian Federation, Ekaterina Kachenko.
Ekaterina Kachenkova wins her second gold medal. She won gold in the giant slalom here, silver in the parallel team event. But Takachenko makes it a third medal and a technical double with gold in the women's slalom.
Let's give a round of applause to our athletes.
Congratulations to our medalists.
Церемония награждения победителей и призеров состоится по окончании второго заезда на основной сцене.